Oh, hopefully I'm on. Okay, we are not muted. Hello, everybody. Welcome to this Revealing the Heartbeat of God, Encouraging Word session. We are so excited that you're here. Seriously, I'm always very excited. Anytime the Holy Spirit's involved, it's always a good day. So we invite you guys to come. And also, if you are able to share this live stream, it is super helpful just to spread the word. We want many people to get super blessed today. But first, I would love to introduce you to my team that is here from around the world. Yay! Thank you, Jesus, for the body of Christ. So we're just gonna popcorn to introduce ourselves. So Nancy, I'm gonna start with you. Go ahead.
Hi, I'm Nancy Patton. I live in North Carolina in the United States, near Charlotte. So glad to be here. Love you guys.
Awesome. And do you want to popcorn to someone else?
Amy, tell
Hi,
us about
thanks.
yourself.
Thanks, Nancy. Hello, I'm Amy from the United Kingdom. It has been a long time since I did this, but I do this quite regularly anyway when in ministry. But praise God, I'm here, and I just hope I'll be able to bless some people today. And Gaius. Gaia, Geis,
Can you
sorry, my
hear
dear.
me?
Grace, sorry, Grace.
Yes, can you let us know where you're coming from, Grace? Can you hear me?
Yeah.
Yeah, good. Yeah, so I am Jace or Grace, and it's great to be here with you guys. I am from UK in Oxfordshire, and it is such a privilege to be part of this team and to be able to bless others and be blessed in the process. Looking forward to what the Lord has in store for all of us today. Thank you. I will popcorn Steve.
Hi, I'm Steve, and I'm from Montreal in Quebec, Canada. And it's always great to be here and hear and see what the Lord is doing. And great to be blessed by you and hopefully for you. And I call upon Willene.
Thank you, Steve. Hello, everybody. My name is Willene. I'm from South Africa, and I serve here at my local church at a school called the Academy of Prophecy. And it's an honor to be with you, and I look forward to seeing what the Lord would like to say to you. May you be richly blessed. So I think that's all of us, Heather. Back to you.
Awesome. Thank you all. So, yes, my name's Heather. I'm actually currently in Indiana. I'm usually somewhere different every time I'm on these events. So, currently in America, but not for too much longer. Anyway, so welcome everyone. So, actually, today, Nancy shared a little bit of an encouraging scripture that I don't know about y'all, but I love reading the Bible. It is so encouraging. So, Nancy, can you share the encouraging scripture the Lord gave you this morning for all of us? That'd be great.
Absolutely. It's from 1 Corinthians 2 and 4 through 5 was the small snippet the Holy Spirit is saying, and this applies to all of us today, saying, "And my speech and my message were not in plausible words of wisdom, but in demonstration of the Spirit and of power, so that your faith might not rest in the wisdom of men, but in the power of God." So we are available this morning, letting the Holy Spirit flow through us, connecting to God our Father, and allowing His heart to be manifest and known as to how He sees each of you through His eyes of love, through the finished work of Jesus. So excited to unveil where He's speaking in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen. That was so good. I love it. I love it. Guys, if you ever need encouragement, just go to your Bible. Seriously, it's amazing. There's a Bible app even. Go check that out. And I just they've even added like devotionals on the Bible app. It's just called a Bible app, I think. It's like a little picture of a brown Bible. But just, God wants to speak to us every day, all the time. So just go, that's one great way is just opening your Bible and reading and seeing God, what are you highlighting or showing me today? So very exciting. All right. So team as well, like I think you guys know, but if you're ready with the word, just write the name. I've posted in the private chat, like the names that everyone's commented so far. And just tell me which one you're interested in giving word to. I'm going to start with James and then Stephen, I'll pass it to you. So the first word I want to give is to James here. And James, what I'm seeing is I see actually like, I see you said you're from China. I see a calligraphy pen. And I know that calligraphy was something invented in China a long time ago. But I just feel like there's something about, I think it's a scripture in Habakkuk where it talks about when we write the vision on a tablet, it makes it plain to be seen. And I just feel like there's something about writing down with the Holy Spirit, like, I don't know, business strategies or plans that the Lord is downloading for you and actually trusting God to make those things come to pass. But it's obviously, it's a homework assignment that you do with God, you know, but I just see you writing it down. And then calligraphy, what is kind of standing out to me about that is the fact that it's something that was invented a long time ago, but it's still something we use today. And I feel like God wants to encourage you that the things he's going to download to you are things that is going to be passed on to others. And it's going to bless people in the future, like both present day, but also in the future. So I bless you with that. And just a radical love encounter with God, because that is always something all of us can benefit from. Thank you, Jesus. So blessings to you, James. All right, Stephen, go ahead.
Okay, I have a word for Gianna Burdett. And at first I didn't know, I just put down your name. I do that sometimes, and then I wait on the Lord to tell me something. And what I keep getting is that the Lord is about to lift burdens that have been on you for some time off of your back. So I think you've been carrying a heavy load, and it's been wearing you down. But the Lord is saying to you, he's going to make you like and I got this term, a little bird. He's going to make you like he's going to make your way light, and the little is not little in terms of effect or impact. It's just your burden is going to be light, and you're going to be giving wings to soar, and you're going to be able to start seeing things that you have been waiting on for ages, that you had almost given up on. But the Lord is saying you have been perseverant. You have kept flapping your wings to see if you could get out and into the air, and he's about to give you flight. And you're going to end up in places that you have never, that you've always dreamt of going to and being in, and you are going to find your own wings to get there. So hang in a little bit longer, because things are about to break and in a whole different direction than what you've been experiencing. So persevere, because perseverance it's a spiritual perseverance you've been doing, and perseverance is one of the foundations for everything else the Lord wants to do. So bless you. And I bless you with that perseverant grace. Can I do a word that I had for the other person here too? Or should I wait?
Oh, go ahead. Go ahead.
Okay. Gem Ree. And I, again, played off your name, and you're a gem, but you're a gem, but you've been kind of like unpolished. And so that doesn't mean that you're not something that shines out, but you're being polished. And so that what it is about you is coming out more brightly. So the radiance of what God has been doing in your life is about to start shining forth in a fresh way. And people are going to be seeing more of what it is that God's been doing in your life. And you're going to start seeing more of it. And the more that happens, the brighter you're going to shine. So you are a gem. You're not a diamond in the rough. You're already smoothed out more than that. But at the same time, your full beauty and grace and everything the Lord is going to do through you in the lives of others, which is a beautiful thing, is still just in the process of being released. So you've got a whole lot more ahead of you. And God is doing a whole lot of new things in your life right now.
Thank you, Stephen. So I have a word for Kerry DePaula. So Kerry, if you're on, this is for you. I really sense that you've been going through a very difficult time and that you've been facing something that's, it felt like a really big giant, something that's not, it's not, it hasn't happened in a short time. It's been coming a while, but it feels like every time you deal with this, it gets bigger and bigger and bigger. And the Lord is wants to challenge you today to shift your thinking, because he says that you are like a buffalo in the spirit. And so I want to encourage you to Google a buffalo, like the ones you get in South Africa. Like I'm from South Africa, so that makes sense to me. But Google what a buffalo does. Even the game rangers are terrified of getting near buffalo because of how powerful they are, and they have massive horns. And I sense that God is saying to you that you are that buffalo in the spirit, and the giant is coming at you as hard as he is, because he is terrified of what you will do when you get your breakthrough. And so the Lord says, change the way you look at this, because you are the one that is scary, not the thing that's coming at you, and you are the threat for this. And so go forth and stand strong. And Joshua 1 verse 5 just comes up in my heart. Be strong and courageous and stand strong in the Lord, because the Lord is with you wherever you go. You are not alone. And as you start to address this, especially in intercession, you will see how you start to chase this giant away. God is going to back you up. So start speaking life and start declaring that this thing is now finished. The Lord says the time is now. Your breakthrough is now. This thing is going to leave now. And so, Father, I pray for Kerry, and I declare her breakthrough manifesting today. And I declare that no longer will she see the giant, but she will be aware that she is the giant, and that the Holy Spirit backs her up with all the power of heaven. And so go forth and be bold and declare and speak, because your God is with you. And then I have a very short word also for James Zhang from China. So I hope that you're still online. James, God is giving you the grace to bring multiplication. So start expanding the way you've been looking at the things that God has placed on your heart. You are now in a season of starting to bring multiplication. And the Lord says, don't look at the 30-fold or the 60-fold, but look at the 100-fold multiplication, because that is what he's designed you for. Amen.
All right. Praise God. That was so beautiful. I've gotten a number of names, but I'll begin with the first and then we'll tag team. So the first that I got is the text was from Medley, and it talked about a word for Trevin. And so what the Holy Spirit spoke, and then I'll flow after I read the words from the page. Jesus says to you, hope is yours. I cancel darkness. Be singularly focused in my light. I have washed, cleansed, and healed you. Be expectant for my glory to shine through you. I am, and I do not change. Be established in my love to you, in you, and flowing through you. And I can just see even now that river of living water that flows in us as the Holy Spirit life permeates your being and your soul. And he's literally just flushing out all heaviness and any despair that you've been experiencing, or longing to know and understand things that have been bringing confusion. I just see the light of the glory of God illuminating not only your heart and soul, but your mind, bringing new and creative ideas, insights, and perspectives, not only of life and the world around you, but of yourself. So captured in the love of Jesus, you are so loved, so seen, and so known that as you even look in the mirror, I'm hearing, you can even see Jesus, and you're beholding Jesus and being transformed into his image from glory to glory. So let your gaze go from the world and any heaviness to seeing Jesus, and seeing Jesus in you, loving you, and manifest through you. So that's what I have for Trevin. And then I had a short word for Rosalyn Naidu. And it began, be established in my love for you. And I just see Jesus, your bridegroom, enrapturing you with so much delight. Oh my goodness. He has so much good intertwined encounter just ready and waiting. So as you immerse yourself in the word and drink in his loving presence through some encounter time in the word, Jesus is taking you by the hand and accelerating the revelation of who he is to you, in you, and through you, and literally wants to show you great and mighty things, like capturing your heart. I just see him taking you by the hand, and you get to be ascended into heavenly places with even a seer anointing to see the heavenly realm and bring it back to earth and speak into other people's lives what you see as this hope just bubbles up and overflows you. Oh, praise God. Very exciting. So I could keep going, but maybe I'll trade off and tag team someone else.
Awesome. I think, Amy, you want to add to Rosalind, right?
I've got also for Medley as well. Is that Travin Medley?
Okay. Did you have any more for Rosalind or that
was... Yes, I have Rosalind as well.
Okay. So you want to carry on with this one and then you can go to the next person?
Okay. I've got a few people here.
Cool.
Okay, I'll start with Rosalind and then go back to Medley, and then I've got Carol Ann and Grace. Okay, so yeah, with Rosalind, I actually saw a bunch of keys. I was just looking through my pile of pictures, postcards, and I just feel the Lord is saying, you know, I have given you keys in my kingdom, and the Lord is saying, you know, look. You know, just see which key is yours. Okay. And I believe there's going to be lots of revelation. And the keys of creativity, I feel, it's like, which one stands out? Which one stands out for you? And a lot of says that you will find the right key to the right door. And I believe that you're probably seeking the Lord for keys in his kingdom. I say, Lord, what shall I do? Where's the key? And the Lord will say, you will find it. Here's the bunch of keys you've got. You've got the whole bunch, but you will be able to find the right key to the right door. So it's not scary. He's given you the bunch of keys, but his wisdom and revelation is there. And he said, that's the one. And that key is for that. So he's giving you that kind of wisdom that you know for sure without a shadow of a doubt, because he's directing you. And also with Medley, I actually have a scripture, Travin. It's in Isaiah 35, verse 10. And those the Lord has rescued will return. They will enter Zion with singing. Everlasting joy will crown their heads. Gladness and joy will overtake them, and sorrow and sighing will flee away. I just believe that the Lord has given you, he's crowned you with joy. Okay, gladness and joy is your portion. Travin. Okay. So, and you'll be overtaken by that. And that's great, to be overtaken with gladness and joy. Not by sorrow, you know, because sorrow and sighing will flee away. So that is an amazing exchange. Instead of sorrow and sighing, you have gladness and joy. And that is your portion. So I bless you with that word. And also, Carol Ann, I for some reason... I saw a cowgirl, not a cowboy, but a cowgirl. And what does that mean? There's something wild there, but it's a good thing. It's a good thing because it's like, you know, that's how the Lord sees you, free. You know, that you're so free, just like that cowgirl, yee-haw, you know, with that lasso and all that. It's like the joy, it's just so much joy in you. The Lord is saying, I've given you that freedom. Because that's who you are. That is your personality. So I don't know if that is true or not. But, you know, he's like, I see you as the free girl, you know, Carol Ann. And he has given you the strength as you ride that horse and doing the lasso, you know, I'm not that good at that, but you know, isn't that amazing that he, that I see you on that horse free. And it's such a joy. And the Lord delights in you. He sees you as the wonderful girl full of freedom. And also lastly, Grace Kim. I saw a door that is like, I am opening the door of opportunities. You know, the time will come. I know you've been asking and seeking a direction, and say, yes, the door is, I'm opening the right door for you, Grace, the right door. So, and it's amazing because he has heard your cry. You know, that you have been faithful and seeking him, and he has heard you, and he's heard you. And there's favor coming. So he's opening the door opportunities, and he's directing you to that door. So when the time comes, you will know. Okay. Bless you.
Awesome. Thank you, Amy. So I have a word for Stephanie Warren. So Stephanie, this is for you. My precious, precious daughter, you have been in a wilderness season for so long that it actually felt to you as if you've been like the Israelites for 40 years. You found water, but then it still felt dry, and it actually felt for you for such a long time that there was just nothing. No matter what you tried, it felt empty, and it felt hot, and it felt dusty, and there was no green anywhere. And you've asked God so many times, Lord, where are you taking me? But I say to you, my daughter, that this is the time now where I am leading you out of the desert. I'm leading you out of the desert. I am bringing an encounter to you now, an encounter of my love, an encounter of my peace, and an encounter of that face-to-face space with me where I will become more real to you than I've ever been before. This is the season of breakthrough. This is the season of transition for you, where I'm taking you from the hard, hard and dry land, and I'm placing you in the lush promised land that I have been giving to you all these years. And I say in Stephanie how God is giving you that promise of Song of Solomon 8 verse 5, where it says that she comes, the Shulamite, she comes leaning on the arm of her beloved, and he leads her out of the desert. And when you come out, you will have such peace. And the Lord is releasing to you fresh vision. He's releasing to you a fresh understanding of his purposes for your life. And the Lord has been training you for a long time. He has been building into your character. He's been training your patience, and your patience has been tested to the limit. But the Lord says that you have passed my tests, and now it is time for the next season of your life. I see how God is going to teach you how to love again. And I'm not necessarily saying romance, but I'm saying you will be able to look at people, and it will be easy for you to feel the love of Jesus for people. And I see that God has anointed your hands for the work that he has placed before you. And God is going to give you such creativity and such a strong understanding of new things, doing new things with your hands. And so the Lord says, I'm anointing your hands, but not just for work. I'm anointing your hands for healing. So place your hands on my children. I will send you the sick. I will send you those who are broken. I see a woman sitting in front of you, and they will be crying their eyes out. And how you just need to place your hands on them and use the comforting words that the Holy Spirit will speak, and God is going to use you to heal his people. God says you do not have to be qualified. You just need to be willing, because I want to use you. This is your time. Amen.
Awesome. Love that so much. So good. You guys, how incredible is this? This is just so cool. I love how when the Holy Spirit speaks, he speaks, it flows out. I just want to point out, like, we also love getting feedback. So if you've received a word, some of you guys have done a great job at writing some of the responses of what that meant to you, which is really helpful, because yes, we want to give out, but we also love to grow in our own gifting. So if there's something that feels off or whatever, please let us know, because we want to grow in what God is doing. I love how, you know, Chris Valentin talks about prophecies like a muscle. You got to stretch it and work it out. So James, love this feedback here. where he says, yes, I'm serving young people who live in the city of Shanghai. So we bless that. We just speak lots of salvations as well in Jesus' name. Also giving words, encouraging words to them. And today's words are really on time. So praise God for that. Also the word that Stephen gave, praise God for a perfect word. Yes, thank you, Jesus, for just all the confirmations. Also one from Jemri. Wow, thank you so much. The last time I had a word about a gem, I was buried, just discovered and unpolished. Thank you so much. That resonates so much. Thank you, Holy Spirit. So it's just so fun for everyone to just, you know, for us to actually hear, like, how is this speaking to you? How is it encouraging you? Also, please message us if you have any like crazy awesome testimonies of words that we've given in the past. We would love to hear how God has used this time on Facebook and YouTube as a blessing in your life. So any testimonies you have to share, definitely, or post it in the comments here. We would love to know. Let's see. Also the word you gave there to Grace. Thank you, Amy. It so resonates. And also I love how Susan made this point. Yay. Hello, Susan. But this is such a great example of, you know, even though Susan hasn't directly gotten a word for her with her name, she's able to take some of the words that were spoken to other people. So if you're on this feed and you haven't gotten a word yet, if there's anything that you hear that's hitting your spirit, guess what? God's got a multiplication and that word is for you as well. So take it if it hits you, because that's the awesome part about heaven is God is a God of multiplication. So just to encourage you with that. And then Stephanie said, thank you so much. I received that. It's absolutely accurate. Yay. And Wilne, I'm laughing because you've actually, I think, picked all the South Africans so far. So I just have to say, I think that's pretty hilarious. I think. I'm pretty sure, though. So that's super fun. Also, just to just throw this out here as well as an opportunity. But remember, if you want to donate to Revealing the Heartbeat of God and what we're doing here, literally this helps us make us be able to move and grow in the things that God has called us to do. So if you would like to give to that, I will post this here. And I will say this. I heard a preacher say this the other day on a live feed, and it's very true. A lot of times people think everyone else is going to do it, so then they don't necessarily do it. So don't think about anyone else. Just ask God what he's speaking to you about. If you are, aren't to sow. If so, how much? All that. Because it's between you and the Lord. But he totally made a good point. He's like, he was saying that there's like 1,000 people on their live feed. And usually they have like 10 people give. And that's what we've experienced. Usually, I think we've had like 2 at the most, you know, but sometimes also none. So it's not about the money at all. I hope you all know that. We love doing this for free. But just be aware, like, if it's something that God puts on your heart, please follow through with it, because it really helps us to continue to grow this ministry and go where we need to go, because we love doing ministry. We love just helping people learn and grow, and that we can expand and go where God calls us to go. So just throwing that out there. All right. So I want to give a word, and then I think Stephen's going to go next, but Jackie Turnbull. So I was totally playing off your name here, but I basically was seeing you riding a bull and holding onto the horns. And I was reminded, and I've probably shared this before, but when I was in Wales at Feldebrennen a couple years ago, God spoke to me and said, are you willing to trust me around blind corners? I'm like, oh no. I'm like, it probably means I have to. Okay then. But what I see you is you're holding onto the bull and it's turning, but it's going different ways. But I feel like God is just saying to hold on. Like, I've had that word before, like hold the line, that kind of thing, because I feel like God is saying like, you're going to go on a wild, adventurous ride with him, but all you have to do is hold on. And in fact, I just want to also release, like, there's a picture, a prophetic picture, an actual artist picture that I saw one time, not like a spiritual, I see a picture in my head situation, but it was a guy that was at war basically, but he was at rest. So he was surrounded in battle, but he was at rest. And so I feel like to just encourage you, it's not about holding on like, oh, I'm going to die, but just like know that you can hold on. But when we partner with that, God's the one that really does the hard work, so to speak, and we can rest in him, but he takes us where he wants us to go. So I just want to encourage you to hold on, and whichever way he turns you, just know he's taking you in the right direction. And I loved Amy's word about open doors. I just feel like it's a season. God's going to open up opportunities. Isaiah 22:22, where it says, what God opens, no man can shut. What God shuts, no man can open. And there you go. Stephen, did you have any more for her, or are you going to do another person?
What I want to say is a couple of things. One, I had the exact same word for you. I saw you as Jockey Turnbull originally. I said, that can't be right. So I looked again, and then the Lord began to speak to me. And then I felt, because I saw it, I didn't see Heather had put her name down on our list. So I was going to, I'm going to wait to see what Heather says. She said almost exactly, I maybe have a little bit of modification. So there's something about very much about this. And but what I said is a bull's a very powerful animal, as you know, and they're very difficult to get to go in the directions you want them to sometimes. And there's a wildness about them. But you're being turned into a jockey who is going to be able to actually turn this powerful kind of almost wild in some ways thing that's going on in your life in the directions that God wants it to go, because you have submitted to God's control. And so it is your name. And it's I was sitting there, I'm playing off her name, same thing Heather said. So I just wanted to confirm that, because that's kind of a double confirmation. So there's something coming your way that's really kind of neat. So yeah, please keep us informed, because I think you're going to start seeing some of this stuff happening sooner than you think. Okay, I also had a word for Josie, and it's funny because I looked down further down the list, and Amy does too. And the word I had has to do with an old movie called The Outlaw Josie Wells. And so I'm there, what in heck? So where's the Outlaw Josie Wells? But it's not because you're an outlaw. I got the word in-law, but it's not because you're an in-law like a relative. It's kind of like an in-law. You are a person who has an outlaw in-law kind of spirit about you, because you're going to be able to break free from your enemy. The enemy has had whatever control, whatever ways he's hindered your walk, has kept you back from going forward in the things that God has for you, are coming to an end. The outlaw Josie Wells was actually only an outlaw because he was being persecuted and his family and different things that happened to them, and he was became a, for that reason, a quote unquote outlaw, but he wasn't an outlaw, and neither are you. But you have an authority and a release that's coming your way, so that you're going to be able to move away from the strategies of the enemy and into the wisdom of God in a whole lot of areas in your life. It's just going to start unfolding. Maybe already has. So you definitely have that on you. And then one more word for Vivian, and then I'll be done. And Vivian, everything about your name has a prophetic significance. There's vivaciousness, like the ability to have a kind of vivacious effect on people in the spirit, so that they're going to walk away feeling like they've just had an experience of I don't know, some kind of feeling better about themselves, even if it's just the way they look or the way they feel or the way they ponder their lives. You're going to have a vivacious effect on them. And also, we have this famous statement that Charles de Gaulle made here in Quebec called "Vive le Québec libre," and it's caused all kinds of untold issues in some people's minds over the years. But it's kind of a neat word because basically he's, and what I saw over you was a "Viva la Vivian libre." So that there's going to be a long live the free Vivian. So freedom is coming your way. Freedom is being released in you. Anything that's been kind of hindering you or kind of making you feel like you're shackled in some way in your walk with God or in what your hopes have been, your dreams have been, the Lord is starting to say, long live the free Vivian. So the freedom that's coming to you is going to be a lasting freedom. It's not going to be taken from you. You've had incidences where you started to walk in those kinds of freedoms. But what was a visitation from the Spirit, in a sense, is becoming a habitation, so that you're going to be able to walk in that and stay in that and rest in that freedom. And it's going to be wonderful because it's going to affect a lot of other people as well.
Great. Thank you so much. I'm not sure what the list is, but Amy, I'm going to have you go next so you can add on to Josie's words so we can kind of keep the names together. So go ahead.
Yeah, Josie, my picture is completely different from Steve. I actually see you walking in the garden. And it's like the Lord is saying, this is my she has the aroma of Jesus, because you are there with Jesus, and you are actually, because you actually host his presence, and he's like, yeah, she's got my aroma. She's in this garden and I'm with her. And that's the beauty of it. It's like, Josie, you have such a intimacy with the Lord that you leak that beautiful aroma, the fragrance of heaven. So, and the Lord say, you know, there's a spring, you know, spring is in your life. That's, you know, that's why, you know, this is just wonderful that, you know, the Lord is just giving you that, you know, winter has passed and then now it's spring. And you're going to start moving in that way, you know, just leaking Jesus, the aroma of Christ. So this is going to be a great time for you. The people will see Jesus in you, Josie. And I have a word for Patty Barton. I've got a picture of this. Where are you there? It's a very peaceful picture, isn't it? And that's what I see, is shalom. I just see peace. You are in a place of peace with the Lord. And in Psalms 4:8 it says, in peace I will lie down and sleep. For you alone, Lord, make me dwell in safety. And I just feel that the Lord is giving you this assurance that you can rest in him. You can be, a, you know, just lie down in peace. And she's saying good morning. Yeah, well, wake up to this truth, Patty, that you can lie in peace with him, because the Lord is the one that helps you to dwell in safety. So bless you.
That was wonderful, Amy. Oh, praise Jesus. So I have a few names that I'm going to press into. So the first is Ethel. And I just hear the flow from heaven of Jesus speaking to you. You're just, your reality in him is established, awakened, and alive. And then he also wanted you to just be assured that he says, I have purchased you. Rest securely in my love. He said, my hope runs rampant through you in luxurious grace. I see a flowing white garment wrapping around you and draping you in my garment of delight. I infuse you with my delight. Hold fast to me, and I reveal to you divine mysteries. I always am holding your hand and leading you onward and upward in me. And so this is a season of a true, even a deeper delight in Jesus. Jesus delights in you, and literally the awakened awareness of his delight for you, and then your echo of delight back to him is going to just unravel any place where you had felt locked in or not belonging. And just being so present in him, he is revealing to you great and mighty things, mysteries that you haven't known before. So abide and enjoy just this breath, the breath of heaven, a breath of fresh air, a breath of revelation coming as just this delight. From the delight, it just opens an expanse of revelation. So very exciting time. And as he reveals, he heals and seals. And this mystery is then unlocking doors and allowing others to see in a new frame of reference, in a new light, as you then speak life into others through this framework of heaven. So praise God. What a voice of heaven flowing through you in those mysteries, Ethel. And then Karen Spicer, I heard Jesus say to you, believer's voice of victory. My hand is upon you to free you from all perception of bondage. You are being unraveled in my light. All heaviness and burden is placed on me. And my light, grace, and purpose, and reality of truth is placed on you, in you, and to you, and through you. And so, Karen, the Lord is bringing, each one is just this unraveling and bringing upward and higher into the revealed glory of the new creation life in Christ. And so an awakened awareness of this light as a burden lifter, a freer, one who unyokes. And then as he does that in the deepest of places in you, you get to then be a hand up and out for those who have felt burdened and heavy laden, to be that hand up and out into the glory, into the realm of oneness and union with God and Christ, who has liberated us. So thank you, Lord, for this awakened liberation. He just invites you, abide in my love. Woo, good stuff. God is pouring out himself into each one. And then Jennifer, I have the word for you, and it's unique for me. I hear a blacksmith. The word blacksmith came to me. He's the one who puts shoes on horses. And then I hear Jesus say, I am establishing you with an even greater capacity of my shoes of the gospel of peace. Woo, woo, you have already had a spirit of evangelism and divine insight, but then I hear you are fully equipped and satisfied in my love and my heart pouring through you in love and compassion for others to share the new and living way of my life resonant within you. So wow. Not only the armor of light, but those shoes of peace, even as Amy spoke the shalom is resting in this abiding place of oneness with God and Christ in such an overflow of passion and liberated glory that this passion is pouring out in a compassion for others to see and know the reality of their lives in Christ. So praise God for those shoes of peace coming on you in every aspect of your life, to you, in you, and through you to others, to bring that shalom, that wholeness of heaven wherever you go, in Jesus' name. Exciting times.
Love that. So amazing.
Thank you for that, Nancy. That was amazing words. Thank you. You even encouraged me with that. So thank you for sharing. So the next person I have is Johan Roche. I am so sorry if I mispronounced your name, Johan, I think. But when I saw your name, I saw Joan of Arc. And if you don't know her, you should Google her. She's an absolutely amazing character in history. And she was a fearless warrior. But I feel that the Holy Spirit showed it to me because you are called to be a forerunner, just like Joan of Arc was a forerunner. And I feel like there's things in your heart that you have wanted to start, but you've been feeling like you are waiting to see who's going to start and who's going to back me up. And the Lord says, you are the person to start the things that I have placed in your heart. And now is the time to start taking those steps. And I feel that what you carry in your heart is a really, really big thing. You have big dreams and you have dreams for the nations, but the Lord says, don't be afraid, because just with the first step, I will show you the next step and the next step and the next step. But I cannot show you the step after the next step unless you start to move forward. And so take that step, because I have called you to be a forerunner. Being a forerunner is not easy. And you're going to have to fight for this, but the Lord will show you how. And I see how he's placing in your hand a big sword, almost like a broad sword. It's not a small sword and it's not a thin sword. It's a big sword. And it's a sword that reaches far. And the Lord is giving you a sharpening stone to sharpen the blade that he's placing in your hands. And he's going to teach you how to cut away the things that will stop you from doing what he has called you to do. I also saw Elisha, not Elijah, but Elisha, plowing in a field. And Elisha was minding his own business in a specific area of what he felt was ministry and service. And then someone came along to pull him out of that life into a new life. Now you are not a follower, you are a forerunner. So stop waiting for the person who will pull you out of the ministry that you're in now for the next step. The Lord says you need to take that step and start it. But if you do this, you will still have the double anointing that you are asking for and praying for in the secret place. God will bless you with double from what you have received from your predecessors, but you must take away the things that have been keeping you back. So I want to speak over you, and I declare over you in the name of Jesus an open pathway ahead of you. And I declare over you now that all fear of the unknown is broken off you. And I release over you the double anointing that God has given you to do the work of the kingdom. You will succeed. Trust in me and trust in my spirit, because I am with you always, says the Lord. Amen. And then the next person I have a word for is Tim Lavenice. And if I mispronounce again, please be nice to me. I'm a South African. I have to learn how to pronounce names all the time. So, but anyway, so Tim, when I saw your name, I heard the name Tim Tam Cookies. So I don't know if you know the brand, but there's a type of cookie called Tim Tam Cookies. And if I recall correctly, they have a packaging that is orange. They're really big cookies too. So some cookies in South Africa are really tiny, and I always want the big ones. So Tim Tams are nice and big. So I feel with that God is pushing you into a season of moving into the supernatural. For me, orange means supernatural. You have been reading a lot of books, and you have been fascinated with the topic of moving in the gifts of healings and miracles, speaking in tongues, prophesying, seeing the unseen specifically. You have a desire to see in the spirit, and the Lord is giving you the desires of your heart. He has seen the hunger in your spirit, and he has seen the hunger in your prayers, and you do not want it for fame, you do not want it for recognition, and you do not bow to the fear of man, but you have humbled yourself on your knees before God, and you have prayed in the night hours, and you have cried, and you have cried for my people, and therefore I will give you the desires of your heart, because your heart is to reveal my face to my people. And so I'm giving you the ability to walk in miracles and in healings and in the supernatural. I see that Jesus is coming to you in your room, and he's touching your eyes, and he's giving you the eye salve of Revelation 3, because there's things that you have repented of that have hurt your eyes, and the Lord is placing his healing balm on your eyes, and he is opening the seer gift in you, and the Lord says, you will see me face to face because you have desired me more than you have desired the gift. So get ready. I am touching you, and I'm pouring my oil upon you. Right now, as you're sitting there, I see an angel behind you, and he's got a massive jar of oil, and it's not a small jar. He's pouring out anointing oil on you. Keep doing what you're doing, because God is going to use you. Bless you. Amen.
All right, Grace, and you have a word? Go ahead. Oh, I love your background too, by the way.
Can you all hear me? Great. So this is a new platform. I'm learning. I have a word for Jürgen. I'm not sure if I'm saying your name correctly or not. Apologies if I'm not. Yes, brilliant. So you're there. Great. So Jürgen, I got a scripture in Lamentations 3, 24 to 26 that says, I say to myself, the Lord is my portion. Therefore, I will wait for him. The Lord is good to those who hope that, to those whose hope is in him, to the one who seeks him. It is good to wait quietly for the salvation of the Lord. And Psalm 27, 13, 14. I remain confident on this. I will see the goodness of the Lord in the land of the living. Wait for the Lord, be strong, and take heart, and wait for the Lord. So the word was so about waiting, but the waiting is not doing anything, Jürgen. It's really waiting and listening and following the Lord's guide. And one thing that came very clear to me was that you don't need to be worried about other people, what they're thinking, what they're planning, and attitudes and behavior. More that thing, or maybe There is a concern about others. So he is, the Lord is calling you to wait on him, to be strong, to be courageous, to be listening, and to be following his lead. Because those who wait in the Lord, they will renew their strength. So the sense is that whatever you're going through, the Lord is in you. And his invitation to you is that you wait on him and do not worry. He's seeing everything, he knows everything, and at the right time, he will honor those that come to him. You don't need to do anything. Just wait and see what the Lord has in store to honor you as you wait on him, as you are strong and courageous to go through whatever you're going through, because the Lord is with you. You are not alone on it. God bless you, brother. Hope this word blesses you too. Thank you.
Awesome. So good. All right, Stephen, you are up and you guys are doing awesome. So we're going to be on for maybe another 15, 20 minutes at the most. So we're going to go as quickly as we can to try to get as many names as we can as we wrap up here. But I hope you guys have been enjoying this. And all right, go ahead, Stephen, go for it.
Hi, I have a word for Matthew. And I think you're looking for a word concerning the season you're living in right now. And the word I got was, you're in a process, a season of processing, but you are in a place of where rest is paramount. And rest is not a passive thing. It sounds like it's passive, but it's probably the most powerful thing you can do, because what is happening is God is calling you into a place of resting so that any striving is coming to an end. There's a thing we sometimes call the orphan spirit. And what that is it's a part of us that always feels we have to strive and do something else in order to get God's attention or to have God's approval. And what the Lord is teaching you is that he already approves of you in a very, very profound way. And that the time is on you now for resting in him, because out of that rest is going to come your destiny. Out of that rest is going to come a connection to things that you cannot make and you don't want to make on your own initiative. It's going to happen because the Lord is going to start giving you very clear things that you do, but you're going to do it from a place of being loved and knowing you're loved, knowing who you are, knowing whose you are, knowing what you're for and why you're for it. And all that's being established in you right now. So you're not in a place of where things aren't happening. You're in a place of where the most important things are happening that are preparing you for what's next. And if you can rest in that and trust in that, it's just a matter of, well, it's not going to seem like it's long at all before you're in the midst of what you're supposed to be into for the next season. So the season you're in right now is the one you're supposed to be in, but it's going to develop and grow as you learn to simply rest and trust. Blessings.
Awesome. All right. I think Amy, you are next.
Okay, I have two people, Miles Tan and Jeff Camilleri. Miles, I had the word. Well, I had a picture as well. Two hands. I think I've used this before. And I just believe the Lord is saying that you have a ministry of reconciliation. We all have a ministry. God has reconciled us for that, right? But he says, but you are especially chosen by him. Okay? In 2 Corinthians 5:18, he said he has given us the ministry of reconciliation. He has given you, Miles, a ministry of reconciliation. So I think this is you have a heart, a desire to bring people together. Okay? And whether it's for the Lord or even for business, whatever it is, but he says that you have this gift of bringing people together, and you have this compassion and love for people, and the Lord says, I'm using that. That's why you are especially gifted in this reconciliation, where there's people who have been in different parts, you know, there's broken people, you know, who really needed someone like you to bring them, you know, just to get them together. And I just see that as healing, bringing communities together. So I see that as that is a gift. And also, Jeff, I have another picture. Someone is climbing, but this seems pretty scary, doesn't it? I believe the Lord is saying, take a risk. I know it's scary, but you know he's with you. Even though you feel like you're dangling, but you know he's still there. It's like, you don't know I'm there, but I am here. Oh, say, take off. Yeah, brother, take off. You can go. You can just climb with confidence. You don't have to be scared, because he said you will reach the peak. So whatever you're aiming for, remember Jesus is holding you, and he's given you, and he's saying, don't be afraid. Take the risk. Climb that mountain. He's given you the skills. He's given you the tools, and you will reach the peak as promised. Bless you, brother.
Awesome. Did someone else have Jeff on our team? If you did, wave at me. I'm sorry. I'm like, okay, no, we're good. And also one other clarification. Stephen, did you have one for Amory? Amory? Except you're muted.
Yes, Amory. I didn't see her name there again. Yes, I did.
Okay. Do you want to go ahead and do that? Sorry, I'm just trying to go in the order.
Okay, thank you. All right. Yeah, I lost it. Anyway, sorry.
Okay.
Yes, Amory. Again, I get a play off of your name. And there's a couple of things, you know, everybody knows the word amor, and it has to do with love, but also I got the idea of armor, and you're being armed with love. And what I mean by that is, it's like, that's your weapon. Some people's weapon is their tongue, and some people's weapon is their you know, their ability to manipulate or whatever. But your weapon is a wonderful weapon, because you're being used to bring love to so many people, and through you, love is just going to flow, and it's going to transform. The reason you're going to be used for healing the sick, for example, is because you love people so much and you hate seeing them suffer. The reason you're going to be used to help the poor is because you can't handle it when people don't have enough, and so the Lord's going to give you what it takes in overflow for them to have what they can't have. So you've got a call on you, I believe, to just let the love of the Lord come out as a weapon in your life. Because, you know, the best way to, and I don't want to get really strange here, but the best way to cast out a demon is to love it out of a person. They can't stand, the evil one cannot stand being around the love of Jesus. And the love of Jesus wants to flow through you. But before it can flow through you the way it wants to, the way the Lord wants it to, you have to let it flow to you. So you need to really center yourself on just how completely adorable and wonderful and absolutely astonishing and beautiful and wonderfully made you are in the eyes of the Lord, and how he just loves hanging out with you, and through you, he's going to start hanging out with a whole lot of others. So just be patient in this season, but focus on that, because you have a call to be an armed lover. And so, you know, we've happened to, I've listened to recently, calls himself a lover. I when I got born again, the Lord told me he loved me. That's how that was how I became born again. So understanding how much you're loved is crucial, because that's what the Lord is making you into, a weapon of love.
Awesome. I love that. I feel like we should all take that word. We all need to be weapons of love. That's what the world needs. It's so beautiful. So I just saw, Ethel, you said, please a word. We actually gave you a word already a little bit back, so you'll want to watch the replay when it happens. However, if you can hop on YouTube currently, Daniel Huffer left you a written word as well. So you got two words, which is awesome. So anyway, go check that out. Also, just give a little bit of awesome feedback, you guys. Thank you so much. Johan said, thank you so much. It's very accurate, and I so needed this word. And Matthew, we just bless you and Marion and their ministry, you guys. They do things that I'm like, I don't know that anyone in the world has the capacity to do what they do. So we just continue to bless your guys' ministry, to Matthew, to you and Marion. Also, just affirmation of your words there. Amy Miles said, thank you so much, Amy. Also, Jeff said, thanks, Amy. Great picture and word. Very appropriate at this time. Yay. And Amori, thank you very much. That is awesome. You guys, this is just so cool. Again, we love to hear feedback as we grow in this prophetic gifting. Also, love what Susan wrote here. Just want to release this encouragement and prayer. She said, for those for whom the pandemic has been rough, I declare that Jesus wants to give you his heavenly sugar in order for you to make lemonade out of the lemons of the pandemic or anything else that might feel like a lemon in your life, and ask God to reveal how he is making things sweet. It reminds me of the bitter waters, like the waters that were bitter, and then God made it sweet. And that's what I love about Jesus, is he's always with us all the time. And anything that might feel a little bit sour or bitter or whatever, God is here to bring hope, to bring healing, to bring restoration in our lives. And he wants to bring the sugar, the heavenly sugar from heaven. So I love that. I just wanted to release that. Remember, if you want to give, the link is in there as well. So feel free to do that. And Vilna, I'm going to pass it on to you. Here we go.
Thank you, Heather. So the word I have next is for Henku Troller. So if you're watching, this is for you. Henku, you have a brilliant mind. And anything that tells you that you're not smart is not of God. And I just speak over you and I command that thing to be silent. You are a brilliant, brilliant person. God has given you intelligence and it is yours. Take hold of it. You are also a problem solver. And so don't be surprised if God places you in a position where there's problems that need to be solved, because he has given you a creative ability to bring his solutions into those places. You can hear from God and you can give his solutions. So you have that ability and you have the ability to bring transformation. And so the Lord says he's given you that ability to analyze and to respond. It is normal for you to consider every possibility, but God is encouraging you. It is time to start to respond to what is in front of you. The Lord says, speak. What I give you, you have the right answer, but you need to speak. So let go of the fear and allow him to speak through you. I am anointing your tongue. I'm anointing your tongue like I have anointed and cleansed Isaiah's tongue with the cleansing coal, the coal of fire. I'm cleansing your speech. That which you have been afraid of to speak before, it will not happen again. I am cleansing you today. But I'm also anointing your tongue and touching your tongue like I have touched the tongue of Jeremiah. Jeremiah could speak and they could not resist him. He could build up and tear down, and he had that anointing and that authority of God. It is yours. So open your mouth and I will fill it, says the Lord. Amen. Then for Daniel Hoffer, I have a word. It's a short one, but I just hear the words elementary school. God is giving you in this season young ones to train, and he is giving you young ones to start to step into your shoes. And so go pray about what that means to the Lord, because I sense that there is a season coming for you where you have to start handing over certain things that God has given you and responsibilities over. And you already have the names that are coming to your mind right now as I'm speaking to you. And it is time to start training the young ones to take over, because I have something new for you, says the Lord. Bless you. Amen.
So it was amazing. Right when Waleen got Henko's name and typed it in, I had the same word. So I wanted to go ahead and wrap hers up with a bow. Everything she said, so powerful, true, and real. And this is what the flow of the Spirit spoke through me to you, Henko. Be real, be alive, be in hope. Rest securely in my love. My love, hope, truth, and power in the Spirit is manifest in you as you press into the heart of the Father. I see you leaning into Jesus as John, the disciple, leaned on Jesus' chest at the Last Supper. And I just perceive such a friendship and intimacy with God that you have, such glory being revealed in you to you and through you. So the encouragement is, be established in my love. Your strength is my strength, says Jesus. See how I operate through you by grace. Rest assured, my favor is upon you. So sealing all that Valine has said is so powerful. And then I have a word for Janu Anthony. So Janu Anthony, I hear a revelation of hope is yours. Hope in Christ, not in the things of this world, but in the radiant glory of the riches we have in Christ. A position of power is yours. Power in the glory of my name. You see above the landscape of worldly realm and see into the realm of my dominion of light. I see you wielding the sword of light, setting hearts free from entanglement of this world and past hurts, and bringing forth the marvel of God's majesty into hearts to see with awe and wonder all that God is, all that he's done, and all that he is doing from a realm of the kingdom of light. You're no stranger to hurts. So the comfort of God's love that is filled and flooding your heart is overflowing with thanksgiving to God. And it's wielding that sword of light to touch others' hearts, to be revealed that the marvel of the mystery of God is unlocked even in trials and suffering, and that each one arises above it in the glory of his name. So bless you, bless you, bless you.
Awesome. Love that. All right, Grace, go for it.
Yeah, so this word is for Dan Webb. If you want that, listen to us. This word is for you. And the verse that I had for you is in Psalm 32:8. And it says, the Lord says, I will guide you along the best pathway for your life. I will instruct you and teach you in the way you should go. I will guide you with my counsel. And as I was just receiving this word, I had in front of me a picture of the world map. Was that sense that the Lord will take you places, Daniel, and he has a plan for you, and he will make the way happen for you. So he will teach you, and he will guide you, and he will take you in the right path for your life. Trust in the Lord. Be open. Be expectant. Things will happen at the time that the Lord says, now is the time. Just be open. Be willing. Be listening to the Lord and be prepared, because you're not going to stay where you are. The Lord has a plan to take you around. I hope that encourages you and give you a purpose for this time right now to prepare yourself for what is yet to come. God bless you, Daniel.
Awesome. You'll love, Grace, to know that Daniel went with Lee Woodward to Japan on their BSSM mission trip together. So Grace has known Lee since he was like 15. So that's a fun little fun little fact.
I had no idea about Daniel.
So that's why I thought it'd be cool to share. All right, guys, we're wrapping up the last few names. Amy, go for it.
Yeah, this is not going to be long. It's for Joine, J-O-E-N-E. Okay, I think it's Josie's friend. Something about this chair, I was thinking, it doesn't look that comfortable, but you know, it's a very sturdy chair. And that speaks about faith. So, sorry if I mispronounced your name, Joine. But the Lord says, I want you to have that faith, like this chair. Okay, sit on this chair. It's not that easy. Sometimes when you have faith in the Lord, times think, you know, you need to be sitting on this chair for so long that you need just have like steadfast faith, okay? That kind of faith that is so steadfast that, you know, it's like, it's going to hold out. This chair is not going to collapse under you. And it's secure. And so I just want to encourage you that you need to, you know, say, Lord, I thank you for that kind of faith, and I want to pursue that. And it's your faith that has held you on, the secure faith. Okay, the secure faith, just like that chair that will not collapse. So if your faith is on him and they're so secure, it will not collapse. You know, it will hold you up. The faith in Christ. Bless you.
Thank you, Amy. Thank you for that word. That was awesome. So the word that I have is for, I'm going to try and pronounce your name with respect, Tan Hui Min Jacqueline. So I'm just going to say, Jacqueline, the word I have for you is, the Holy Spirit says, I am making you cheeky. I am making you cheeky this season. Now, what does he mean with that? He's going to place you in positions where there's conflict. You're going to see conflict happening in front of you, and God is going to give you the boldness, the cheekiness to step in and to say something. But what he is doing is, God has called you to be a peacemaker. He's calling you to be a peacemaker. And so when you see the conflict, step in and speak, because God is going to use you to release his peace. And he gave me the scripture of Matthew 5 verse 9 that says, blessed are the peacemakers, for they shall be called sons of God. And the Lord says, in heaven, you are known as a son of God. You are known before the angels as one of the royal family. God is well pleased with you. Be bold, step in and speak, for I am with you, and I will use you to release my peace. Amen. And then I have a word for Basil Jacob. Basil Jacob, you have wrestled me and won. And that is referring, I was just reminded of that scripture where Jacob was wrestling with God in the night. He was afraid and things were coming at him and he was wrestling. And that is where he got a limp. And but he won that. He said, I will not let you go unless you bless me. And the Lord says, Jacob, you have wrestled me and you have won. I am giving you what you have asked me for. But the limp will be there and it will be seen. But the limp is not a negative. The limp will be part of your testimony. And because you will be honest with what I have done in and through you, be transparent and share the journey when you release your testimony, because that will be the breakthrough for those who will hear your words, in God's words in your mouth. So speak. You have received the blessing. The wrestling match is over. Now you will walk out. And as the people see and you share your testimony, the anointing is on you to release breakthrough to them. So bless you. Amen.
Okay, I think I'm next. I have a word for Susan and for Elaine. And Susan, I know your story too well, so it may come across as, but I was hesitant to say it, but I kept getting the word burden lifting, because I know you've been under a heavy burden lately. With your parents, but and everything else has been going on, but I felt the Lord saying, "No, tell her that I'm yoking myself to her burden." So you and the truth of it is that you're yoking yourself to Him, but He is actually going to help you in that process, so that you're going to experience what it is to be yoked. And when you have that and you understand it, it's going to enable you to do more than you can ask or imagine right now. And because you've been wondering, how am I going to be able to do the things I'm being called to do with all this burden, with all this other stuff going on? And what the Lord is going to show you is that this is a season of preparation. It's a season of process for you, because you're going to be enabled to carry heavier loads in the future than right now you ask or imagine. But it's going to seem light and easy, because His yoke is light and easy, and that's going to make your yoke easy. Oh, Elaine, I first said it. I said, I'm going to take the risk. I think, and the way the word came to me was because I can't let, and it seemed funny, because the Lord sometimes does a sense of humor thing with me. And I said, I can't let Willene take every South African that's on the list. So I decided, well, okay, so I'll volunteer. And as a Canadian, I'm going to speak this. So what I saw, though, when the Lord began to build on that, because He sometimes does things like this, is that I feel that your ministry is about to become more international. And maybe it already is to some extent, but there's things happening right now, and you maybe even have been pondering it and processing it and wondering, is this, because you're somebody that, despite the fact the Lord has lifted you up and put you into places, you're not ambitious. You're not ambitious in the slightest way that prevents the Lord from raising you up. And those issues, I think, have been dealt with long ago in you. And so the Lord is saying to you now, dream big, because you're already dreaming big, but dream big because your dreams are centered in humility. And that humility is what has raised you up to where you are now and is what is going to raise you up in the future. So embrace it, because you've had all kinds of challenges and all kinds of things come against you. You've had criticisms. You've had people point fingers. You've had accusations. You've had those kinds of things happen in the past. And your response was, but I'm not really trying to do anything. I'm not trying to be anything other than what I think the Lord is telling me to do. And that obedience, in spite of all the things that have tried to prevent you from moving forward, has become something that has made you a special treasure in the eyes of the Lord for things that he wants to do through you in the future. So you have, it's not that you're just beginning to see, but the Lord has going to open your eyes in wider ways to see that what you're giving away in terms of attitude to those that have learned from you and are becoming prophetic themselves and are moving out in their own authority is something that has been given to you because you're so willing to give away whatever it is the Lord gives you. And he's just expanding on that and going to keep on doing it. So I hope that rings a bell, and I haven't wandered off and outside of my realm into South Africa too much. But anyway, you definitely have something happening that is very, very exciting. Bless you.
And Elaine, even as Stephen was speaking, I just kept getting this picture of you positioned in the righteous right hand of God and him just elevating you. I kept seeing it. So I just had to share. And I also wanted to give a word for Katrina. And the Lord says to you, your maker is your mirror. God sees you in his magnified glory. His power rests on you in splendid ways of insight, rest, and power. In your position of grace. And the Holy Spirit flowed to speak a word directly to you. He invites you to continue to behold me. As you behold me, my light and radiant glory is manifest in you, to you, and through you. I hold your hand. I walk with you. Be established in my love. Your voice matters. You hear me, you see me, and I am magnified in and through you. You are a mighty woman of God, and God sees you as such. I just even see a megaphone even projecting from your mouth, because the words you speak, just like that original scripture we spoke, they're not in the power of man, but in power of the Spirit. And so just realize that God's radiant glory and light are truly magnified in you, to you, and through you. You're so loved and precious and special. Love you, Katrina.
All right. And then Grace, go ahead. Last one. And then I will wrap up a few names and then we're going to finish this feed. Go ahead, Grace.
Okay, so the words that I had is for Cindy Burdett. Cindy, if you are there, this word is for you. So I got for you Isaiah 49, 15, and 16. In the words mainly that I heard clearly was that you are not alone. God will never forget you. He has your name, Cindy Burdett, written on the palm of his hands. You are special to him. You are known by him. He loves you dearly, and he has a plan for you. You might not know right now. It might not make sense to you what his plan is, but he does. And trust him that he knows what he's doing, even if you can't figure that out right now. He has your name, Cindy. Cindy Burdett, written on the palm of his hand. Do you know what it means? Means that you are very precious, sister. Mm-hmm. Means that you are very special. Means that he will never, ever forget you. Your parents, people that are dear to you, might forget you, might disappoint you, but he will never, because he sees you, he's with you, and he will never, ever forget you. Bless you, sister. God bless you. I hope this word of encouragement really encourages you today. Thank you.
Oh, thank you. That's awesome. So just a few more words here. So my friend Jean from South Africa, we have a theme going on. So funny, I know that you have a shaved head. I'm sorry, that's all I can see when I'm asking God what he's saying. But I feel like he's saying he's got you covered. He's got you covered. And I even see like sunscreen being put on and all that. But I just feel like God is saying he's got you covered. And I just feel like he wants to encourage you that just like the sunshine comes out and radiates. I know y'all are, what are you about to go into winter or whatever? But I just feel like God wants you to know, like, the sun shines every day. And there's a whole word that a friend gave about how even on a gray day, the blue skies are behind a gray day and the sunshine always comes out. So I just want to bless you with that God's got you covered and the sun is always there. And as you know, I know you love him so much, but just he wants to remind you that he's literally pouring his sun, S-O-N, ship on you as you continue to walk with him daily. So I bless you with that in Jesus' name. And then let's see, there's another couple here at the very end. Nico, I love that name. You know what? I gave a word to a guy the other day where I saw him. I actually asked him, I said, do you have Nike shoes? And he said, yeah. And I said, well, just go do it because it's like the check mark. It's already there. Like Jesus has already said, yes, go for it. And I feel like that's what the Lord is saying. I see you like almost running, like wearing Nike shoes and running with him. And I feel like God is just like there was that one Chariots of Fire. I forget his name right now, but he said that when he ran, he felt the pleasure of the Lord. And I feel like even if you're not literally running, because like I don't run. In fact, I don't run so much that one time, little snippet, but I was like in a market in England and I felt to give this girl a word, but she like ran off and I'm like, yeah, I don't run. And guess what? 30 minutes later, God brought it around that she ended up standing in a line, hundreds of people around. And I was able to give her a word and it was such an encounter. And I was like, yeah, I really don't run. but if Holy Spirit has an assignment, he'll make sure you get to the assignment. So I feel like the Lord just wants you to know, Nico, that God's already said yes. Just run with him as you do, as you step out, as you enjoy life with God, as we live out this fabulous, like amazing life that God has given, these adventures with Jesus, you are literally going to see the pleasure of the Lord on your life. So just keep stepping out with him. Really quick, Tim, your wife, Ashley, I just feel like you're in a season of blooming, like here in Indiana, you know, spring is here. You guys are in Pennsylvania, I'm pretty sure. So it must be similar. But I just feel like you're in a season of blooming and I literally see buds blooming. And in fact, I did a word the other day that I'm going to release on Revealing the Heartbeat of God. I haven't done it yet, but a little video about how God is taking the dead things and bringing things back to life. So I just want to speak that over you. So watch out for that video. That video is also for you and how God is going to bloom new things in the season. Cody, it's kind of random. I don't know why. I just saw a picture of a dog and dog tag or whatever. But I feel like God is just saying, like, you're never like lost. You know, like I see a dog out there, but it's like the dog tag always means it can find its way back home. And I feel like the Lord wants you to know you're going to find your path. You're going to find the way because God is going to bring people to come along and help you to get you where you need to go. So I want to bless you with that. Let me see. One more name, I think, here at the end. So Janine Peters, you know, I'm just getting that verse in Luke where Jesus said to Peter, like, it's time to step out of the boat and follow me. And I feel like God is saying, like, there's extra big risks that he is actually asking you to take and to follow him. And what I love about that scripture is that literally Jesus starts this by saying, do not fear. Do not fear, Peter, because I'm about to radically change your entire life for the rest of your earthly life. I know that's kind of like intense right there, but God is saying it's time to step out and you're going to see incredible and impossible things on earth happen because God said so. So I bless you with that. So friends, thank you all so much for joining us. Team, you all were amazing today. You guys rocked this. So, so cool. Guys, I love the body of Christ. It's incredible. Oh yeah, we love all these comments, guys. So we'll go through and check all those out. But guys, we bless you. And I'm thinking about that verse about let his face shine upon you. The Father is smiling over you. And just remember, like, he is a good, good Father, and he loves you, and he's here to walk with you and just to walk with you through everything. If you're feeling low, he brings you high. So to a higher place with him. So we bless you all so much. And remember, if you want to give into Revealing the Heartbeat of God, it's posted there. And we all send you guys so much love and see you in the future. All right. Blessings, everyone. Bye. Bye-bye.